Okay guys, now let's do a very, very important area, that is which one? Your entire committee of Creditors. So 17, 18, 19, 20, all that are over, now 21 committee of Creditors. Before that, we need to do some basics relating to the concept of home buyers. If you remember, we discussed one Karnal Avasthi versus AMR infrastructure case, where what happened? The thing is, they took money from this Karnal, hard earned money, and then they built one skeletal structure, did not give him his house. So this guy went to the court and he said, I want to sue you. So am I a financial creditor? Am I an operational creditor? Am I a, what do you say, corporate debtor? Definitely not. Am I a financial creditor or operational creditor? Doubtful. Because you have not given him any credit. You have not given him any money. A time value of money, it is not there. Consideration for time value of money. Have you provided goods or services? Has the Karnal provided goods or services? No. Has the Karnal provided loan? No. So obviously this was struck down, unfortunately. Second one, this is the first case. Second one we discussed was JP infrastructure. In JP infrastructure, JP's infrastructure subsidiary, correct? One more JP buildings, you know, constructions. This was the main JP infrastructure limited. So they had this dream home project where they collected 25,000 crore from 32,000 home buyers. And then they, through a complex structure of layering, they laundered this money to various other places, including the JP Infrastructure Limited, whereby these people put it in the Yamuna Expressway building project. Skeletal structures were just established, and when the 32,000 home buyers asked for their property, they said, who are you? I don't know. I want to sue you, they said. Please sue me. Where will you sue? Financial creditor, operational creditor, nothing. And conveniently, JP, this went on for IBC. They only went, applied as a corporate debtor. And when you are opening the assets, nothing is there. Supreme Court, as we have discussed, Supreme Court in a public interest litigation put, they lifted the corporate veil of JP subsidiary and they said holding company is liable. Before the holding company, before Supreme Court could do anything, JP infrastructure also went for IBC. Convenient. Money wiped out. So, that's the reason why. What was inserted? Section 58F. 5 in the financial debt ka definition, F was inserted as an explanation. Any amount raised from an allottee under a real estate project will be deemed to be an amount having the commercial effect of a borrowing, thereby bringing the entire home buyers into the ambit of what? IBC. If you are an aggrieved person, you have given money more than 1 lakh rupees now to whom? To the company. Then you can definitely sue. In this context, there's a very, very interesting case, friends, which we have to remember, and it is an important Supreme Court judgment. Important Supreme Court judgment, and that is this case. Let's see that. Very, very interesting case. Pioneer Urban Land and Infrastructure Limited and another versus Union of India. Very, very important. Landmark judgment. Pioneer Urban Land and Infrastructure Limited was decided 9th August 2019. Around a year ago, over a year back. Supreme Court of India decision. So I have read it up and collected the gist and what I felt. So what they said was, if I allow these people to come, it is going against RERA. That is what the builders said, going against RERA. It is going against also raising the property. Every Indian can hold the property as per the Indian constitution. Various articles are there, 19.6, 19.1G, 300 capital A. But there are rules and regulations following that particular property, which again is governed by RERA. Can some other authority take it over? Was also the question of law raised. So what did the rule, what was the decision? They say Amendment Act to the Code does not infringe anything. The RERA is to be read harmoniously with the IBC. It is only in the event of conflict that the code will prevail over RERA. That also they told. Code will prevail over RERA. Remedies, so basically the builder said remedies are also available in RERA. Why are you coming to IBC? They said remedies that are given to allottees of flats are therefore concurrent remedies. They can also avail the remedies under the Consumer Protection Act 1986. Correct? The new consumer law 2020 has also come, by the way. Correct? So he is telling that 5A-TEF is actually originally appeared only before. It is already always it spoke about allottees and flats. The explanation is not an amendment. What they were trying to tell is this explanation which came here, which came on 6-6-2018 is not an amendment. It is an explanation which anyway was given before only. Just for clarification, I have given this. The question was whether the allottees were included before 6-6-18 or after 6-6. They said, boss, since the code is there, from that only time only it is allowed. We already knew it. You didn't know it. So, that's what they are trying to tell. Wonderful decision. The explanation with the deeming fiction is only clarificatory in nature. Correct? So the legislative judgment in economic choices should be given a certain degree of deference by the courts. They are trying to tell whatever the judgments that are taken, whatever the legislative, See, generally guys, every act is prospective. Every amendment is prospective, not retrospective, unless the intention itself was something else before. What was the intention? The lawmaker is telling, boss, it always included in 5A-8 only. Consideration for time value of money. I give you money. You tell me that you will give me the house in 2 years. You don't give me the house in 2 years. Which means 1 day delay. Don't you think so? It is consideration that I gave you for time value of money. Yes. It's already included. What is the big deal? So basically what the court should say, the Supreme Court said, when this liberty taken by the lawmaker, I need to respect, should be given deference, means respected by the courts. Brilliant decision. So the most important reason, obviously, is they have told, the Insolvency Law Committee also found this, that there was a delay in completion of flats, etc. It is becoming a common phenomenon. So because of which home buyers are treated as financial creditors, so they can trigger the code under 7 and have the rightful place at the Committee of Creditors. Correct? Is just clarificatory or can it enlarge the scope? So as I already told you, even without an explanation, I can clearly say that all real estate products is subsumed within 5A-TEF with respect to time value of money. Subsumed means what? It is very much a part of 5A-TEF. Correct? The allottees and home buyers were actually inserted before only main provision. The explanation in 2018 is merely to clarify the doubts. Brilliant decision. And section 88 of RERA, when we see RERA, we'll check that out, that they are merely in addition and not in derogation. Section 88 clearly says, Section 88 of RERA says it is merely in addition but not in derogation. Derogation means I am not going against any other law, it is merely addition. SEBI also tells the same thing. SEBI is merely in addition to, not in derogation of what? Companies Act, any other law. You cannot agree that RERA is a special enactment, that's why the special provisions will apply, nothing like that. They say that the code must be given precedence over RERA. Harmonious construction has to be adopted. I have to give effect to both the provisions. And RERA cannot be a special statute, it should go hand in hand. The builder said, sir, under RERA I will give them all the fine. Why are you going for IBC for me? Why are you going IBC against me? Correct? The code deals with rehabilitation of the corporate debtor, whereas RERA protects the interest of the individual investor. You haven't paid the money back, you have not completed the project, which means some other management has to come and take over. The remedy in RERA is additional remedy and not an exclusive remedy. And moreover, I can go to Consumer Protection Act also. Now the question arose, okay, how the hell are you financial creditor? So that is the thing. So if you see the amendment, they very clearly said that we should understand the legislature and appreciate why they amended it. And when the Insolvency Law Committee is already doing it, they have checked out the constitutionality of everything. So you cannot say financial creditors are different, home buyers are different. But one problem will arise, guys, now. Deadly problem. In this decision, what was the final thing? Can home buyers apply as financial creditors? Answer was yes. But you know what the deadly thing is? There are certain speculative home buyers. When you go to buy a house, do you really want to buy a house? That is one part of it. There are other people who just use this as investment. I have loads of money, corona scene has come, real estate properties are low, rate is low, go buy. Speculative. Many people indulge in speculative. They have become kingpins, so rich because of speculative transactions. Speculative home buyers. What speculation? They'll come. They'll pay the base amount and you have to pay me. The moment there is some problem between me and you, of the 1,000 home buyers, the company has satisfied 800 home buyers, no tension. 200 some issues are going on. And mind you, these issues can be from the home buyers also. They would not have paid one installment. So these fellows are constantly reminding. Home buyer gets pissed off now. He goes to NCLT and says these fellows are IBC. There is some delay from these people also. No problem. But you also have not paid money. You are supposed to pay 40 lakhs, you have paid 37 lakhs. And now you are jumping telling I already paid almost everything. Why haven't you given me this property, this particular possession, why haven't you given me? I'll say, sir, pay 3 lakh rupees, then I will give. So what you will put case against the home buyers, sorry, against the, sorry, financial, I mean the company, real estate company. So guys, what I am trying to tell is, there are certain trigger happy, that's what, trigger happy home buyers. They are waiting to press the trigger. So one question that the pioneer in that the Supreme Court only asked, yes, now I agree home buyers can be financial creditors, but one problem that I envisage, brilliant decision, there are trigger happy allottees who are igniting the process of removal of management. After the prima facie default is made out, the burden shifts on the promoter or real estate developer. That allottee is himself a defaulter. I told you, no, you have not paid. Mr. Allottee, you only have not paid. And you are not entitled to any relief. But now you have the audacity. I told you the other day, Airtel broadband doesn't give me proper service. So I have clearly told them, I will not give you 1 rupee money also for this month. Bill they have sent me 1.5 lakh rupees. I have told I will not pay. Tomorrow IBC notice against me, saying that you have not paid. Exit the management. Dangerous. So they say insolvency resolution process has been invoked fraudulently with malicious intent. The allottee who has knocked at the doors of NCLT is a speculative investor and really not interested in buying the flat. Because he knows that if he buys the flat under RERA, but he wants to jump ship back, jump ship, immediately have to go and sell it somewhere else. RERA has some other, you know, hidden provisions, all that protection will be there. So this trigger happy what to do was a big issue. So Supreme Court only gave wonderful directions, guys. I have researched a lot on this and collected all this information for you. These are the statement made by the Supreme Court. That's why I said it's a wonderful decision. They have told, I am going to protect the genuine home buyers, but for the speculative fellows, I have to give some directions. States or union territories shall appoint permanent adjudicating officers, RERA authority. So Karnataka RERA, Maha RERA, all these things. Within a period of 3 months from the date of this judgment, they will look into all these things. NCLT and NCLAT shall be manned with sufficient members to deal with litigation that may arise under the code, and especially from the real estate sector, within the second week of January. Stay order shall continue until the NCLT shall take up the application. Decide the light of this judgment, they will take up the application to see the facts of the case, whether it is a speculative investor or whether it is a genuine investor. Speculative or genuine investor. So guys, this decision triggered so many things. This came when? Sometime in December only. Final judgment was January. But it started obviously sometime in November. Government was closely following this particular judgment. Very, very closely following this particular judgment. What did they do? What did they do? Under RERA, under IBC, how many members can give, guys, the notice? The IBC notice? Home buyer? One home buyer. So there are 1,000 home buyers. They have aram se fulfilled 999. One kirik party will always be there. That party has gone for IBC. When all other people are happy, one person has gone for IBC. And how much has he given? What is the default amount? 1 lakh. All others have done crores of business, no problem. So I also need to protect the real estate company. Because of this, there is a threshold limit that was inserted during the course of this only. You check it out. That is Section 7. Who can apply? Section 7. Subsection 1. Proviso. Insolvency and Bankruptcy Amendment Act 2020, which came from 28-12-2019. When will it come? First time ever? Coming soon to an exam center near you. Right? Are you understanding the logic? This is because to give credence to the wonderful observations of the learned judges of the Supreme Court in the pioneer urban case law. Second proviso you read. For the financial creditors who are allottees under a real estate project, 7.1, second proviso. Application for initiating CIRP against corporate debtor shall be filed jointly by not less than 100 of such allottees under the same real estate project. or not less than 10% of the total number of allottees under the same real estate project, entire group is there. That also was happening, by the way. See, in a real estate project, guys, there are various phases: phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. Is this an entire project or each phase is a project? What is it? Any idea? One full area I have taken. Phase 1 is constructing, phase 2, phase 3. Is each one a project or this entire thing is a project? Each phase they will separately register under RERA. Phase can only be for that area, just for us to speak, but in RERA it is a different project altogether. Each registration, each project, correct, separately registered under RERA. So friends, this one is separately registered. So now I am here, my friend is here, for me no problem, but little kirik happened. There were actually, you know, there were a lot of fights between me and the friend, me and the real estate company. So I told my friend, since yours is not there, you go put a case. No way. That's why they have given what? Wonderful language. Under the, okay, all this will remove. Under the same what? Under the same real estate project. Means under that particular registration. You have a problem, you come. You alone can't come. I know you are a speculative in this thing. Real estate fellow. How many people should agree? 100 such allottees. Or not less than 10% of total number of allottees. 100 allottees. Or 10% of total number of allottees under the same project. Whichever is higher, whichever is less. Less. Some special homes are there, only 30 homes. 10,000 square feet, 5,000 square feet, 30 homes project, that's it. In that what, 100 allottees. That's why 10%, 3 people. 3 people, correct. Or 100, whichever is less. There are projects where 10,000 homes, 1,000 homes, 2,000 homes and all are there, no? But you know what the practical difficulty of this was? When should I see? At the time of application? Allottees means what? Who have been allotted the project. If there are 3,000 homes, only 300 are filled up. Is it 300 or 30? So should I see at the time of application or what? These are some practical difficulties which need clarification. By the time clarification came, Corona, statue. Correct? Where real estate? No money to even eat food. What real estate you will buy? Correct? So if you see, all this will slowly come. But this is the practical problem. This was the practical issue. Understood? So this is the scene. Very, very important case that come. But again, one more deadly thing came, guys. Deadly. February 4th, 2020. Umang Real Tech Private Limited case law. Umang Real Tech Private Limited. Important. Under this, you know, legislation, Mrs. Rachana Singh and Mr. Ajay Singh, along with the entire flat buyers association, they made a flat buyers association. They went to Umang Real Tech. Umang Real Tech was a real estate company, corporate debtor now. Rachana Singh, Ajay Singh and all they are new financial creators who are the home buyer category. They have followed this also, no problem. 10% of allottees or 100, no problem. Done. We are all flat. Actually, initially there were only two. Umang, what did they say? Pioneer, Pioneer, Urban. Come with 100, no problem. They went to the flat. They actually, association starts when? After it has been allotted. Here at the time of buying only they created Flat Buyers Association. All of them went and said, you have not given us our properties. And under RERA, you allot the property, and then once the certificate of completion actually is done, occupancy certificate, once it is given, then you need to create the association. That is also an area where you can work on. Right? I'm just saying. Various aspects for a chartered accountant to do. One is IBC, and one is, you know, if you are interested in RERA, you can go there. That's the beauty of economics law. Paper 6D. Right? So, Rachana Singh, Ajay Singh, they came first. Then they said, hey, Pioneer, come with 100 people. Okay, come, 100 people. They came. And they put this against Umang. They said, boss, enough is enough. Now, I want you to fulfill the project. Sir, but you put a case against me under IBC, which means I have to go, somebody has to come. You know what these fellows said? I don't want you to go. Weird. I don't want you to go. I want you get the money somehow now. I will ensure you will complete the project. I want this house. You're a nice guy. House is amazing. It's my dream house. That's the attachment. I will also be there. You bring somebody on board. I don't want you to go. You're a nice guy. I don't want somebody else to come and take over and all that will never happen. You do it. This was the first ever such case. Yeah, you can actually call it as suit for specific performance. Perform the contract. But then if I perform, suit for specific performance will generally go under civil court. But here I am through IBC going. The judge was baffled. In IBC what happens? You will come to me and you will tell, you throw this fellow out, other fellow. IRP, have you appointed IRP? Yes, sir. Sir, but IRP will not throw out that person, sir. IRP will handhold that person. Weird request in front of the court. And under this thing, you know, there was this promoter. Promoter also was a company. Uppal Housing Private Limited. They told the promoter, you be the intervener in this entire deal. They requested you be outside the CIRP process. Don't come in and take over. Play the role of a lender. And please ensure everybody gets the possession. Please. That is the most important thing. Play the role of a lender. Lend money. Then I went to one more financial services company. JM Financial Credit, Financial Credit Solutions, like that one company was there. I went to them and said, you please be the financial institution, you will get 30% of, you know, whatever paid to the allottees. This entire scheme, whatever 30% amount, whatever we get, 30% you take. But you also pump in some money. NCLT had never seen a petition like this. This is not CIRP. What is this? Reverse CIRP. How reverse? Generally what happens? The corporate debtor gets out. IRP comes in. New person is appointed. Here they are saying you stay. CIRP without CIRP. This is a landmark judgment, first ever reverse CIRP in our country. Have you ever heard of it? Yes. Flat Buyers Association of Winter Hills, Gurugram versus Umang Real Tech Private Limited. I have explained the entire thing. So, CIRP against a real estate company is limited to a project as per approved by the competent authority and not other projects which are separately and separate plans and separate RERA registration is there. Yes. You know why they agreed to this? Who is a financial creditor? One very simple guys, who forms the COC? Financial creditor means who? Home buyers. Who is the main person here? Home buyers only. There may be other people. There may be people who gave money to the real estate company, all those things. All other people were, they were, had not made any default. Only to home buyers they had made a default. So these two people, Rachna Singh, Ajay Singh, they said, you know what the court asked? You will come sit in the COC, form everything. Sir, I don't know anything. You please get me my possession. NCLT is full in dilemma. Should I allow them to run the show? How will home buyers have that expertise, guys? Just think about it. To run a real estate company. What will they discuss? It is going to be only, see, at least if it is SBI, then UCO Bank, Dena Bank, all these fellows, if they have given money, they have that expertise in running the show. They will hire IRPs, they will constantly talk to them. Home buyers. So home buyers will be at the mercy of their authorized representatives who can do whatever they want, who have zero experience. Okay boss, you are a chartered accountant, you are a resolution professional. Do you have experience in real estate? Yes sir. What? I opened magicbricks.com and see all the houses. That's it. Do you own a house? No sir. Do you know what is super built up area, carpet area? Do you know how to build a house? No, sir. Then what you will do? What you will take over? For 180 plus 90 days, what you will do? So, peculiar request. That was the basis of this decision. Amazing decision. Right? These are all amazing, amazing case laws, guys. The allottees, home buyers come within the meaning of, okay, but they do not have any expertise to assess the viability or feasibility of the corporate debtor. COC, will they work on specific project? Yes. There are four phases going on. I am working on this. Other people are working on other three. How does it matter? So, Umang will work on other three phases. But home buyers of this particular phase will work on this phase without any knowledge. Correct? They don't have commercial wisdom like financial institutions. These allottees have been provided voting rights also for approval. So, the NCLT said many such cases came to our notice where allottees are the sole financial creditors. This judgment is of 100 pages. I had to take out the relevant parts, no, to give you the perfect meaning. It is not made clear as to how they can assess the viability and feasibility. Then they again went to that case law that we have discussed. Remember, Innovative Industries of ICICI Bank and Swiss Ribbons and SR Steel. Three amazing decisions. In terms of the court, resolution plan must maximize the assets and balance all the stakeholders, secured and unsecured. Home buyer is secured creditor, unsecured creditor? Unsecured. Secured creditor, all the banks, do you have any problem with Umang? No sir, they have all paid loan, everything they are servicing, no problem. So home buyers will come and take over. Weird. So infrastructure which is constructed for the allottees is an asset of the corporate debtor. Assets as per the court cannot be distributed also. Who has to take over? IRP. So secured for secured creditors actually. In the entire scheme of things, who will be paid first? Even in winding up, who will be paid first? Secured creditors. On the contrary, who are unsecured creditors, assets which is the infrastructure is to be transferred to them. Why are they saying here, I want my house. House is what? Asset. Isn't it? Stock. For Umang Real Tech, what is house? What is that each flat unit? It's a stock. Normally, banks would not like to take flats and all. Imagine. bank, give me 10 crore, take this flat. I don't want your flat, give me my money. On the other hand, unsecured, I have a right over the assets. In most cases, committee of creditors always take a haircut. It is called haircut, guys. The COC always take a haircut. The resolution applicant satisfy them most of the time with lesser amount. In case of the allottees, you will take, sir, give me 3 BHK, give me 1 BHK and 1 toilet. Other two don't want. What haircut you will take? Are you understanding the practical difficulties of home buyers being included? Generally, the resolution applicant will convince the financial creditors for a haircut. Here, what haircut you will take? Sir, I bought 3 BHK, give me 2.2 BHK. No. Hence, and it's always a project specific CIRP. Project is defined in the, you know, RERA. It's actually, it is, definition there is very wide, but ultimately it also covers phases of a large size project. If it's doing more, see, basically RERA will apply for more than 8 flats in the same premises. So each building would constitute a project. And if there are 4 phases, each phase would constitute a separate project. So what will you do? You will take over everything. Correct. So it should be project specific is what they said. And also, how will there be maximization of assets when you are taking away the assets? How will the people give the money? Problematic. Correct. So if the CIRP process is commenced with a particular phase, what happens to the second phase? All these are issues. And ultimately, the primary source in value would be what? I should also give preference to secured creditors at the end of the day. Now you are unsecured, you are taking away everything. That is why, guys, India's first ever reverse CIRP. CIRP would involve imposition of moratorium, verification of claims, approval, nothing. In this, what it is? Very simple. Reverse CIRP would imply that the project of the corporate debtor does not stop but continues so that home buyers can get their homes. And resolution professional can maintain the company as a going concern. Projects can be completed at the given time period, interest of the allottee, survival of the real estate companies, and to ensure completion of works. They gave directions. They may be some allottees who ask for refund, but that prayer cannot be allowed. No refund. Why? Who lost refund? Speculative fellows. Pioneer, see? We have read that already. NCLT held that offering allotment is open to an allottee on the request of the refund is totally to those, whatever, if the project fellow agree, otherwise no refund. House only you allot. Intervener is directed to cooperate with the IRP and disperse the amount. Flat shall be completed by 30th June 2020. Corona. Gone. Where? No, it stopped. This didn't happen, obviously. All internal fit out electricity, 30th July. Corona, statue. This came in February. When? Where was Corona? It was just coming that time, no? All these processes should be completed by 30th August. Sure. Right? If it is completed, CRP could be closed after intimating AA. The resolution cost including fee will be borne by the promoter. Imagine. Only after get no COC, promoter. Only after getting the certificate of completion, only then I am going to close this case. Brilliant decision. And IRP can still sell the unsold flats by way of a tripartite agreement between purchaser, IRP and promoter. Think about it, guys. Deadly. Proceeds may be generated, can be used for project completion. And I told you, Rachna Singh and all these things, they have to be given. Key takeaways and the way forward. So this is similar to a voluntary restructuring negotiation process, which is already there in the UNCITRAL model, that is United Nations Commission on International Trade Law. They already have this model there. They already have this model. This is the first way of, you know, adopting it in India. This will become a law in the future, guys. For home buyers, 100%. Take it from me. 100%. It will be called as a voluntary restructuring negotiation process, where I will talk about eligible debtors and all these things. Umang Real Tech. Then other things, it's fine. So if you see expression of non-confidence, because single person it was needed before, now it is minimum of 10%. Correct? So all those things, other things you leave. So this is a very, very good decision in Umang Real Tech case. So that is the scene. This is the concept of reverse CIRP. Did you get it? Reverse CIRP. First ever reverse CIRP in our country. This is the scene with respect to home buyers. Now you can ask me, sir, home buyers, when they come to COC, how will they be? How will they vote? That is why, by virtue of section 21, which we are going to do after the break, we will understand what this home buyer has to vote. Will he be able to appoint somebody else? Yes, that somebody else is called authorized representative. So the authorized representative provisions are all covered under 21.6. Then it is covered under 25 capital A, voting as per 24. This will be discussed post the break. This entire basics was needed for us to understand what is the voting mechanism. How will they vote? Is it one flat, one vote? Or is it with respect to the money that I have given? All those things. Because home buyers have been, have come into the picture, because of which this entire thing has come into play. So who all can be the corporate, this thing, what do you say, debtor and all those things? Who can be the financial creditor now, even the home buyer? So before we go for the break, I will show you this revision animated video of 2 minutes, which is going to help you understand the entire home buyer scenario. I mean, why the home buyers came into it, just who are the people who can apply under this thing. What do you say? Who are the people who can apply to the court, to the NCLT, that is under which one, guys? Under which one? Under this entire IBC. So it's a very short video. After that, we can go for a break.
Hi. In this video, let us discuss the persons who may initiate corporate insolvency resolution process. As per the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016, popularly called as IBC. Under IBC, a company who owes a debt to any person is called as a corporate debtor. The debt can be of two types. One, financial debt, and the other, an operational debt. The person to whom a financial debt is owed by the corporate debtor is called as a financial creditor. The minimum default is 1 lakh rupees. So if a bank or financial institution or any lender lends some money to the corporate debtor, and the corporate debtor defaults payment of minimum 1 lakh rupees, then the financial creditor can initiate the CIRP. That is the corporate insolvency resolution process, with the approval of the National Company Law Tribunal. If the corporate debtor owes an operational debt to a person, such a person is called as an operational creditor. Who is an operational creditor? He should either have provided goods to the corporate debtor or should have provided services. He could also be an employee of the company. Any debt due to the government, like local taxes, etc., also is an operational debt. So under IBC, a financial creditor or an operational creditor can apply to the tribunal. If the corporate debtor defaults on payment of 1 lakh or more and initiate insolvency proceedings, whereby they take over the management of the corporate debtor. Interestingly, under IBC, the corporate debtor can also raise the white flag and voluntarily apply to the tribunal to initiate insolvency process. So there are three people who can initiate the insolvency process: the financial creditor, the operational creditor, and the corporate debtor itself. Now assume the corporate debtor is a construction company into real estate business. A prospective homeowner pays the first installment towards booking his dream home. The homeowner is not a financial creditor. Since he has not lent money to the real estate company, the homeowner is not even an operational creditor. Since he has not provided goods or services to the real estate business, or is also not an employee, so is there any remedy to the poor homeowner who has been cheated by the real estate business? The only option seems to be the long winding pathways of the courts, where resolution would take years. Thankfully, the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Amendment Ordinance has amended the law and has inserted the clause where amount paid by real estate allottees will also be considered as financial debt, thereby giving a lifeline to the hapless homeowner to take the fraudulent real estate company to the insolvency court.